Hey y'all. A couple days ago, might have been yesterday, I did that Styx song Lady, one of the early ones. And it got me thinking about other Styx songs that might be worth doing. And I thought of Come Sail Away, which is basically a piano song until the, you know, second half of it. But thought that might be a good one to do on the fly and just learn it. Now, I haven't sat down to play it. I've heard it 10,000 times. I was 10 years old in 1978, so trust me, I heard it 10,000 times. Just giving it some thought, I haven't put it on yet, haven't started to play, tried to play with it yet, but I'll bet we can figure it out without even hearing it. There's a couple of things. Since it's basically a piano song, you can assume it was written on the piano. So chances are pretty good it's in one of those piano keys like C or F, right? Because if you're going to sit down and write a guitar song, generally speaking, yes, there are plenty of them in C and F. But generally speaking, you'll go in G or A or D, maybe E, something like that. But piano songs tend to be around C, like Let It Be, you know, those kind of piano tunes. Hey Jude, so. And that one's in F, Let It Be in C. So you can make some educated guesses. So I'm gonna guess C because to my ear, F just sounds like it's too low for that song. So my guess is it's in C. So that intro part I know goes do, 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 right? And this is one of those songs where for me, it's easiest to think of the bass line first. So if it's in C, that's going to be the intro. I'm guessing here, but we'll see in a second. I'm guessing that's it, right? So it's C to D minor, because that's a minor chord. Because if you go C to D, that ain't right. So if you do C to D minor, and then another minor to E minor, back to D minor, back to C, then G. Probably F major 7. Then back to G. To C. A minor. To G to F. So we're into the on board, I'm your captain. A minor. To G. A minor, back to G, and we'll try, oh, we'll try, A minor. That's what I'm guessing, and we'll find out in a minute. But then it goes into that, the rock part, right? But that doesn't sound quite right to me. Because the one thing you can hear through those rock chords is the C ringing. I mean, you'd have to figure out, how do you do those chords, right? With the C note still ringing. Well, for me, that means it's up here. Right, so that's just C, F, G, F. So to do that G and still have the C note underneath it, so you just do a regular C, barring an F, but keeping the bass note at C covered, and then you have to do the same on G. So what you do is, this is really the chord that makes the song in my book. Regular barring your G way up here. Except you have to do it with these fingers instead, because this one has to cover the C. So it is just a G barred, used to bar it. But you gotta keep that C covered there. So it is. So let's play through it, and I'll do the guitar chords underneath the intro, even though it's not a guitar part, just to see if we're right. And of course, if it turns out this is, it's not in C and these are the wrong chords, I'll just delete this and you'll never know. But let's do it anyway, see what happens. This is the short version without that big instrumental part in the middle. So it turns out we were pretty darn close, and You know, for people who don't know how to learn songs by ear, that probably is seems amazing or something. It's not. For starters, if you've figured out hundreds of songs, it becomes sort of routine to do it. But, you know, we started with a few, one or two, just pretty fundamental guesses on how it would go. The first one being, what key is it in? And really, once you figure out that it's in C, the rest of it, you could see how logical the chord progression is. And rock songs, pop songs, usually are pretty logical. The ones that aren't, you know, kind of stick out in your mind as being not logical. But this one is, I don't want to say predictable, but it goes where you expect it would go. And once you get C, the whole rest of it, because the bass lines are well put together, and they make perfect sense. So if you are ever stuck on something and trying to figure it out, try the bass line first, like this one. Once you get the bass line with this, all the chords fill themselves in. It's pretty easy. So good luck with that. I don't think you have any trouble. The only mystery chord in there, in terms of the fingering, is there's one that's like this. But that's our best that we can. That's just a G, except you're only playing the four middle strings of it. A at the second fret, D at the third. It's a transition chord, or a partial chord, that often gets used for walking down from C to A minor. You could also call that an E minor 7, with the same two covered. But I think of it as a G. But it is an E minor 7 also, a different way of playing an E minor 7. So good luck with that, and let me know if you're in trouble.